A lot of people don't realize that they do science in everyday life just by seeing a problem, figuring out or asking the question, why is this happening, and then testing it somehow and determining, okay, this is why the problem is occurring, this is what we can do to fix it. That's the scientific method, and it's everybody does it.
The beauty of the scientific method is, first of all, we observe the environment. And from those observations, we come up with questions. And from those questions, we come up with possible answers to those questions and hypothesis or hypotheses. And then we create tests to test those hypotheses to see if they indeed are correct or not. In order to test an hypothesis, we collect data, analyze that data, and then come up with a conclusion on whether or not our hypothesis was correct, or was it close, or was it incorrect.
Every day, we will have things that come up that don't work exactly right. We know how we think it should work, but when we do our work, we look at the results and we say, that's not the way it happened yesterday. What happened here? And then we go back and we've made extensive notes as to who did what time it was done, what procedure was followed, and we also make notes if we notice anything that is not the same as it was the day before.
Paleontology, like any other science, has to follow strict, rigorous methods to be truly scientific. It is possible to speculate about things and have a lot of fun doing that, but if there's no scientific rigor in it, then it's really not a very important avenue of thought or exercise. What I mean by scientific rigor is that a strict hypothesis needs to be formulated, data has to be acquired, and then you test your hypothesis against that data.
So that's what the scientific process is. Initial research of the problem, the formulation of a hypothesis, the testing of the hypothesis, and gathering, concluding something out of your work.
People often think that we go out and we try to find fossils to prove our ideas. And that's absolutely the wrong way to look at it. What we do is we set up a hypothesis and we go out to find fossils to disprove our ideas. Hypotheses in science have to be falsifiable. That means you set up a hypothesis that if you find the right piece of data, it's going to knock your whole idea down and you have to start again from scratch. The way science works, and paleontology as well, is that you start with an idea, you test that idea over and over again, and if you can't overturn it, you develop more confidence that you're on the right track.